Well, good day. Welcome to another Song of Ffraed video. The Song of Ffraed is my journal of a sacred assignment to restore a vital presence, that of a weaving, dynamic, autogenous, swirling mass of every coloured energy, often only seen as white. Its internal patterning is constantly changing into the shapes that we can recognise in the art of our ancestors and the fractals of modern mathematical awareness. That isn't a guess, it's what I've seen. The only two in a throwing is within herself. Because this mighty life energy is a she. Her realm is throughout all creation. She is the Holy Spirit. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And a darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light.
So I just follow whatever you do. It lets you what we could do and things.
I'm going to be, she comes in through the arch.
Right.
So I'm going to pick her up where she comes in through the arch. And what she'll do is she'll go there and then she'll go and through into that building where we've just been. Yeah.
Okay.
If you want to film, like, she'll go, we're not meeting her, she'll go like that.
And you want to follow just directly behind?
You want to catch that? No. If you stand.
Like that, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're ready?
Yeah.
She'll respond by going like that. Right?
Okay.
That means yes, yeah?
Okay.
So, hi Ffraed. This is Chris, he's come to help Matt today.
Good morning.
So there you go.
Chase?
She's acknowledged you and said good morning to you as well. You have to be sort of quite cautious because she can be very subtle in her movements. You could miss if you went too fast. So it's a little spiral. Thank you. see how the architecture's been designed around
her. Mm.
She's central to that window there, she's central to that beautiful window up there. And to that window up there, so it's a piece.
Mm.
I've designed the building around her. I've encouraged her to pattern. so elaborate, isn't it?
Yeah.
Amazing. She drew something extraordinarily beautiful there, but I'll show you what it was.
That was amazing to watch.
Yeah.
This is really fun. Thanks, Ffraed. Ffraed. This is amazing to watch. Here with Ellis. I met him at the Holy Grail documentary in Swansea. Catch up.
Have events here, so benches of. Right. in there. I can't get in there, so I'll pick her up where she comes out.
Okay. Thank you. Is that a standard pattern she does, what you've just done?
No, she, during her healing, she does lots of different patterns and changes every time.
Right.
She still, she keeps the same general route, though some rooms she goes into and once she's finished in there she doesn't go back again, but later on she might. She's just really kind of, as we were talking about yesterday, gathering in the energy. And, and distributing how she likes, and a lot of the spirals she does, it's kind of like somebody winding in wool.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's some cat's guy and tangled it all up, and she's bringing it all in together, and then she'll use it to create the pattern she needs next time. So the next time we go, it'll be some elaborate pattern, but those skeins of wool or whatever are not there anymore. She's used that to create a pattern.
Is that what you feel in your hand with the, what do you call it, the rod? The,
yeah.
What do you feel?
Her energy.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'm kind of like one with her.
Right.
So, there's some really good drawings of what these places were, so these places used to look like. And these
okay.
Yeah, next time I come again, it'll be changed, the patterns will be changed again in some of the rooms, and some will be the same. That's say four leaves or four petals, but if you look at in between, it's actually a cross, like a temple cross.
monk.
Now she follows the river to the main road, over the bridge, and turns left and goes into the cathedral.
Right. Cool. That was amazing.
Oh, glad you enjoyed it.
Yeah. It's like I wouldn't have walked around there like that without... I just walked around a ruin.
That's right. That's exactly it. You get kind of in the energy of the place. And you have a new respect and view of it. You know, brilliant.
Yeah, it's good.
Everywhere you go, you know, everywhere she takes me, that's how it is. And it's brilliant. Yeah. I can't sort of chat while I'm doing it, so I've stopped every now and again. Because I'm in that space, you know, it's to be perfectly accurate, you have to be. So. Yeah, it's brilliant, isn't it? It's amazing.
So where are we going next?
We're going to have a coffee, I suppose, because we can't go in the cathedral because there's a service on.
Okay, alright.
But yeah, once when I came here with Jono, followed her to here and she went off there.
Yeah.
And brought me back again and right in front of my eyes, to show me something, right in front of my eyes was this little satanic witchcrafty type thing.
Just like a little monument, like a little artifact.
Blood and bone and all bits of nasties. It was some sort of a curse.
Wow.
Curse thing, you know. Like a poppet, but not a poppet. You know, that sort of thing. I don't know what they would call that thing. So she showed me that. I haven't seen that otherwise. It's like usually she goes to them, instead she went, took me around there, made it so that I was looking directly at it.
And did she want you to remove it?
Yeah.
Wow.
She did. Yeah. Pretty cool, huh?